hip hop style.
I wanted to interview you, Luck, because you know, there's a lot of artists and that have embarked on a career of doing music, and when things don't go their way, of course they go to the wayside. They hit the 9 to 5, which is nothing wrong with that. You dig what I'm saying? But in that span of time, just give me brief pockets of what you've been doing and what you've been up to keep yourself relevant.
No, it's about working hard. It's a lot of people who supported me along the way, like a lot of people who carried me when I couldn't walk. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it's not about what I did. It was about what everybody who believed in me did. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because it's already a cold world, so if it was any colder, I probably wouldn't even be doing music right now. Like my friend 11, he would always harass me and send me beats and want to promote and doing mixtapes and stuff. And it's just people like him, they get on my nerves, but they kept me going. You know what I mean?
Well, but see, but that's what makes it authentic, in the sense that people believe in you. What made you say, you know what? This is not my path. What made you pull back from the music?
It wasn't me. It was the music. They pulled back from me. I've been hot. Y'all sleep.
Yeah. Well, but yeah, but look, you know what? Forget the labels. I mean, you did that. You know what I mean? You hit hard with labels, actually. And in the process of me knowing you throughout the years, of course, I always seen you put out a mixtape. You've done your music. You've done this.
It's not. It was. I can't take any. It's so hard to put into words. It's like this, right? I didn't know what to do, you know, so after I left Def Jam, I decided to do the independent thing before it was what it is today, mm-hmm. before social media was what it was. I went through a bunch of investors, nobody knew what the hell they was doing, and neither did I. So it took a lot of me learning, you know, because I thought the music industry or the music business was just music.
Mm-hmm.
I did not know about the business part. The business part is like 90% of it. You get what I mean? So it was a lot of me not knowing what's going on, and then like, people wouldn't fuck with Luck. I mean, what am I supposed to say? I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. Like, it's labels out there and there's rappers out there. People saw me in these streets.
Of course.
It's not one rapper who didn't see me in these streets with my mixtapes. It's not one basketball player who ain't seen me. So it's not like ain't nobody say, hey, Luck, what's going on? It took a whole nother genre to help me with, you know, my life and stuff like that. Now everybody call it.
But you know, but that's a good thing. Mm-hmm. Once again, you went through, it was like you going through a metamorphosis, you know what I mean? Like it was a process. You had to get to that stage in order to say, you know what? I love this, and despite whatever goes on, I'm going to continue to do what I do.
I'll be so honest with you.
Come on, keep it in mind.
I don't want to take no credit for nothing. I'm just here. What happened was, me growing up, there were different people who would come to me and say, God has a plan for your life, but you're going to go through many trials and tribulations. Now, none of these people had each other's phone numbers. It would be one church that I go to, it'd be a stranger on the street. So they just didn't tell me how many is many trials and tribulations. I wish they gave me a number on it. So for years, I've always wanted to stop doing music, because when you're unsuccessful at something for so long, to continue to do something and expect different results is insanity.
Mm-hmm.
So then you have to face yourself in the mirror. It's been so long, you know, are you insane? But in my shoes, I could not stop, because if I stop doing music, then that means I can't believe in God. Because
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
This is the promise that God has given
me.
So then you sit there and you go, no music, which you love, no God, which you totally believe in with your whole being, that's a dark life. So I'd rather just keep doing it and keep
there
knocking, and he got to come through, because I'm here because you told me, man. Where
right,
you at?
Right.
It's getting cold.
Talk to me about this mixtape. Or is it is it an album?
Well, I have two things dropping. I have I don't like calling it a mixtape,
yeah,
but it's
an
album that I'm going to put out for free for the most part. The facelift. And it's just me and my feelings. This is music that I've recorded, just being in my feelings, you know. And then, the album She God would drop in when the show bombs.
First of all, the album. Well.
Oh yeah, She God. She
yeah,
God.
Yeah, no. Let's rewind that. Right.
Facelift. Yes.
Facelift.
Yes.
So this is one you're giving out free.
Yes.
So we got our boy 11. Is 11 part of that project?
No. The facelift is free. You know, just gonna do videos for it for the people who are fans of Lady Luck and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But 11 has my biggest single on the She God album.
Okay. Hey, why not?
Me and 11, God willing, me and 11 gonna run next summer.
Okay.
Yeah, the She God project we're gonna drop next year.
Okay, facelift.
And we're going to drop as soon as possible, hopefully for Christmas. I'm waiting for the cover to get here because the young lady drew a painting for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to go get it digitalized and put it
into
an album cover. Yeah.
Oh my.
And I'm going to hang it on the wall.
you know, look, what's amazing about that, right, is that once again, throughout these years, how do you feel about now putting something out, right? Mm-hmm. People at you now, right? The attention was always on you. Don't get it twisted.
Mm-hmm.
Despite what you may feel, the intention was always on you. But listen, so the album itself, is it a compilation? And I say in the sense that, do you have like a multitude of different artists on it, or is it you?
No. On the Facelift project, it is my homeboy Murders featured on a song.
Mm-hmm.
I reached out to Miss Jade and Babs to do a song.
Okay.
This holidays, it's really hard. Women do live regular lives outside
of
that. But, So it's just me for the most part. I got my cousin on the hook. I got my homegirl Grace from London singing
okay.
on it.
Okay.
You know, maybe somebody else is on there. I smoke weed, but and then we're always changing the track listing, so I don't know which one y'all gonna get by the time y'all get it.
How did it feel going back into into the studio?
I've always been in the studio.
Right.
Like I said, it's been y'all that was asleep. I always been in the studio. I never stopped because I'm dope.
That
like,
you are.
Know what I'm saying? They'd be like, well, why am I going to stop? You know, now I'm not going to go record. I'm dope. So, you know, I always did that. It was more of a me writing R&B songs and pop songs and stuff like that. I was writing for my cousin.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, this She God, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, I guess this is where you at with it. Like, you know, you when you said face of, you was just like, now, and moving forward, right?
Mm-hmm.
We get this show. I'm like kind of thrown off. Talk to me about the show. Give me the title. Break it down.
What, She Got, or we just skipped over that?
Yeah, we just skipped over that, because, you know, I'm going to come back to that.
The show's, it's coming on TV.
You're going to give me something light, huh? You're going to give me something light.
I mean, just basically about my family. My family is hip-hop royalty. They're the first rap record label out there. They put that bag up and got that record played. And my cousins are also wanting to get into the music industry, so I'm on the show. Initially, I was writing for my cousin Leah,
mm-hmm.
and we were working on her album together. And then she decided that she wanted to, you know, venture off and do her own thing. And I was like, What? You'll see on the show, it's a little different
yeah.
than that, but yeah, so then I started working on my project, focusing more on my project.
Mm-hmm.
Like, actually, like, I'm doing this. I've always recorded songs. I got a bunch of fire. I got a bunch of trash.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you just keep going. Everything's not going to be it. And, yeah. I got hundreds of songs.
That we know, but I know you want to be strategic about it as well.
Well, I mean, yeah, we're just putting out dope shit. The dopest of the dope shit, you know. But don't take my word for it. We're just here.
Right.
It,
you know, and I'm not gonna take it, but you know, there's a slew of different types of sounds out right now.
Mm-hmm.
Where you at with it now? Who is it that you leaning more towards as far as music is concerned?
I'm not leaning towards anybody. Mm-hmm. I had a problem with the new music at first,
mm-hmm.
right? Because the era that I'm from, everybody rap like this and nervous. You're like, oh my God, you know, it's like, whoo, rewind that. That's why you had to rewind it. Because
mm-hmm.
you're like, what the fuck did he just say? You know, you couldn't calculate it. Then the music nowadays, it became so doped up and down that it's like it's different.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of fighting against the current, you roll with it. And I've you know, one of the artists that helped me realize that is Fabulous.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And listening to different artists who can still stay consistent, you can make music a different way.
Right.
So then I started doing music, not like them, but in the same groove of it, because it's all still music at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
You know
mm-hmm.
what I mean? So I could do the same, but my words could be doper.
Of
you
course.
Know what I mean? My
of
metaphors
course.
Would be doper. Like, it would be a message in it, opposed to, you know what I mean? So I love everything that's out there. Some of the music makes my brain melt. I'm not gonna say the artist.
Right, right. We're not here.
Shout out to Celine, if he watches this, because my cousin Celine, he plays some shit. I'd be like, how do you do this? How? How are you not dumb? Like, you in college? I mean, yes.
Well, I mean, the good thing about it is that you didn't sit here and downplay nothing that's currently out. You know, I feel that a lot of people, especially when you get to a certain age, you just downplay it all, F it all, you know what I mean? So as an artist, it was good to hear.
Where I'm from is 242, I4I. I always looked at Somaya like, when she came to New York, I didn't, you know, of course she had a lot of things popping, but it wasn't like, you know, how it is now. So mm-hmm. I looked at her as my friend, you know, she do music. Then when she did Love & Hip Hop, I didn't look at her as she's on Love & Hip Hop. I looked at that as my mm-hmm. friend did the show.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I'm saying?
Right.
So then, like, you know, we start messing with each other, and I went to L.A., and we had a little, you know, little frisky tongue-kissing pictures. The next motherfucking morning, I go to the bathroom, I'm doing media takeout, and I see me and her with the pictures. So I'm like, oh shit, oh shit. So then finally I'm going on and now it's hitting all of the blogs, me and her kissing. I'm about to have an anxiety attack. All I keep telling her is, I didn't know you was this famous. My man, this shit is on fashion and style. It's on VH1. Well, I'm turning to her like, damn, you famous. I call this nigga, I call my parents, right? I said, hey, Ma, you know, I want to let you know that some pictures is coming out. What kind of pictures? I'm like, well, you know, me and Somaya, what you doing? I said, well, you know, we got pictures kissing. What kind of kissing? Here, tell your father. I'm like, what? So I'm like, yeah, daddy, you know, because I'm outside the restaurant about to have an anxiety attack, all right? My heart is beating. I'm like, yeah, daddy, you know, there's some pictures of me and Somaya. He said, we out now, nigga.
Anything, there's truth in every lie in every truth, my confidence.
I'll give it that sound. I'll take to it.
Yeah, it took me a very long time because I'm admired for the style that I had. Mm-hmm. You know, so it's like, well, why do I have to change? These niggas is whack.
Right.
But you gotta get off your pedestal. It's different from the music you like. Just mm-hmm. like your parents' music is different. So it was a lot of growing and it's a lot of growth to be like, you have to see what's the current state of music and fit sonically in there. Yeah.
Any other business ventures you know? You
indulge in? Oh, shit, it don't stop. It don't stop. Now that everybody is picking up the phone, we got everything from sunglasses to
sunglasses.
Yeah, sunglasses to adult, you know, toys.
Talk about it. I mean, listen.
T-shirts. I mean, hoodies. I mean, it's just everything. You never know. God is so good. Somebody had asked me one time in the interview, they was like, luck, so what's next? I said, shit, I don't know.
Right.
I said, you asking me? I'm just here for the ride. I didn't know I was going to meet you 2 weeks ago. You know?
True story. Like, true story.
I didn't know this all was going to happen. Everything just goes boom. So I know it's the person who fails to plans to fail, but that's bullshit to me. I just stay prepared. So right. That's my thing. Like, maybe my life is different from everybody else. The people who, you know, have to plan to go to school and all that other shit. I'm a Sagittarius, so I'm just free in the wind. But I follow God because I ain't playing none of this shit. I ain't go, all right, so, yo, we're going to go hunt Bravo down. You know, we're going to do the TV show. Then, you know what I'm saying, me and Somaya. Ah! Then we're going to go, you know, we're going to pop. We're going to get our own spin-off. I mean, it's just crazy. I didn't do none of that. I was just there writing songs. And then everything was like, hey, you ready? Align myself up with the universe. Cut a lot of people out my life. Jesus,
oh my.
Christ, all of it. If they're not celebrating you, then they are like fucking killing you. Like, I could not see it. So majority of the reason why it took me so long to get elevated is because I was around so many people holding me down. So you be thinking, yeah, my niggas holding me down. No, they really are. And like, I promise you, I ain't gonna lie to you, Terrell. As soon as I drove to LA by myself, took me a month and a half, stopped everywhere, and I found peace, you know, because I realized arguing with people, you have a choice. Like, I don't want to argue. I don't argue. I hang up the phone. Why? Because I ain't argue for a whole month with nobody.
Right, of course.
Then you realize, like, the people who you're around, like, people say corny shit. People do corny shit. You can't let none of it slide.
Story of life or something.
None of it slide. Like, a lot of my homies right now, I'm so heartbroken. I didn't change not at all. I'm too much in my chakras to worry about any money or anything, man. I know that we need earthly money for me to get done the things that I need. But I ain't into none of this fame shit. Nothing. I've been famous my whole fucking life. Look, let's keep it real.
The resurrection, I love it.
But with rebirth, whatever, the phoenix, whatever you want to say, you know what I mean? My whole thing is that people that I was like, we're going to go get this money together, I'm going to hold all my niggas down, acting crazy. And he knows that I'm not the bitch to change because everybody who has helped me, I call them in. Yo, you got to come do this. Yo, these people give me some money, they give me a camera, come on. You know, everybody, you should see what people are texting me and saying. It's heartbreaking. But how I look at it is the airplane. My friend Sounds, he said the spaceship about to take off. Spaceship about to take off, and a lot of people have taken themselves off the flying list, you know?
Of course. Well, it's a good thing, though. I mean, in reality, sometimes people have to go through a process of refraining.
Heart.
But it's a process. Listen,
I love these people.
Yeah, but you know what? When we embarked on it, you know, I said, listen, our relationship was 10 to 15 years we've been in. You dig what I'm saying? And that process, I've seen multiple artists fall to the wayside. And some tried to resurrect themselves, but couldn't. So you had a point where you went through that. You know what I mean?
Number God, that's it. I just ask for him, give him more glory. You know what I'm talking about? That's it.
I dig it.
He said that to me today. He was like, yo, man, I'm so proud of everything you're doing. I said, what did I do? I ain't do nothing but don't give up. If there's anything I can tell anybody, just don't give up. Like, don't give up. Look at the people who did Macarena. They was like 80 years old. You know what I'm saying? Don't give up. One of the biggest
personality, hits right? Personality. You gotta love luck. Personality to the T. Personality to the T. In the business venture, you know what I mean? Talking of, you know.
No, it's just people calling and they have good ideas. I mean, Somaya is like a genius, as I can say. She is like a. So let's give Somaya. Can we give Somaya Reece a round of applause?
Yeah,
see, what happened was, I came out the valley of the shadow of death. Remember, I was telling you, I called my friends up. And she was there with this rich white Rolls Royce and this towel. She wiped me down. She said, let's go with this fucking money. So, I mean, her tea company is out of this world. They ain't like them other bitches with their tea. All right? Somaya Reece, the Get Slim Detox Tea. I had some last night. It was such a
You're looking
peaceful.
Marvelous as well.
He always flirting with me. Be respectful, Terrell. All right. It's nice and smooth. I heard you ladies out there getting cramps and stuff like that. Listen. Shop This Fits Me. We have plenty of products for everybody. You men need it too. It's not just tea. I don't want to just degrade her.
Somebody, you got a tea bag here?
Not the mocha.
You know what? I don't have one on me.
All right, but we have fibers and everything to get you nice and going clean on the insides of yourself.
Bring that over to somebody. Look at her. See?
She didn't clear this one, so don't go nowhere and stay right here. He's smart. You don't just put a camera on a Latino without asking.
Grown up in the Bronx, I've learned to, you know, manipulate certain situations.
Nah,
you dig it?
Bro, I didn't. Yo, Terrell, I am learning. I am a student in Somaya Reece class. I'm serious, bro.
I dig it.
I was sitting there, she be screaming at me. I'm like, nah, I'm smart. She's like, well, you shouldn't have did this. You should have did that. I was like, yeah, all right.
Well, listen, it's good to have great people around you. You dig what I'm saying?
I've been blessed. I prayed to God when I was in D.C. by myself driving home. I said, God, please bless me with better people in my life. I want better friends, and I want to be around better people. And he did it.
And as you see, luck is here. She got a slew of different things coming on, coming out. Like, right? This is people's. Anybody else, I'd have been like, damn, man, sweating this shit. Like, come on. You dig what I'm saying? Luck.
Yes.
Love you. Much
She
success.
Got album is dope. I got
yes.
my father on there, my song Recognized. Somaya got a verse on the song. But it's not a gay song. Like, I want to clarify that. You know what I mean? Like, we got a dope record as two human beings. You know what I'm saying? It's not a homosexual record.
Look. You are something different. Listen.
It's a dope record.
All right. Yo, look, listen.
It's a dope song. You know what I mean? Like, you can listen to it and not feel gay. All right?
No, listen. Can I add on to that?
Right.
I wanted to add on. Since you said that, right, you know, how do you like the atmosphere of the world
the
now?
Games?
Right? When you first hit, it was just something, right? Just to fucking...
You've been working out. Dude.
Yeah. Right? So it was something just to say, you know what? I'm of this cloth as of now. So for you just to throw that out there, how do you feel about just what's been going on as far as the music is concerned? You know, people claiming their sexuality, they're stating this and they're stating that. How do you feel
we
about that?
We know what he's trying to say. Let's just pull it out.
Pull it out.
Pause.
Talk about it.
I'm grateful. You know, sometimes it'd be like, I never took a sucker approach with it. When I look at it, I'll be like, y'all niggas is corny. Because a lot of people I've dealt with, they were like, nah, look, I can't mess with you because you do that. Or, you know, they treated me a certain way. Ah, it's your image. And then, you know what's going on. And it's the same people like, whoa, this is crazy. And I'm like, ah. So that part of me, even though people allow growth,
Right.
And we're in a different time frame and we're in a different time zone. So I'm totally appreciative of it, you know? Phew, I wasn't the first one that had to do it. But I mean, it ain't even me. It's been other female rappers. I don't know if they claim they set yet either, but I ain't the only one in this party, you know?
No. Shit. I'm asking you, though. You dig what I'm saying?
I don't know. I'm just trying to keep it real political.
I see. You're taking a traditional approach.
I just learned to just care about nothing but what we're doing.
There you go.
I have, like, so much going on. It's like I'm appreciative of the music, you know, and the doors that are being opened before me. Like, I appreciate the doors Nicki Minaj kicked down. I appreciate what Foxy Kim did, Boss, Rage, Nicki D. Like, you know, they were the ones before me, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then I kicked down the door for you battle rap bitches.
Yeah, that's another story,
you
right
know?
There.
So it's cool, you know. It's like I'm appreciative of everybody who's contributing to the movement, but I got so much going on, especially waking up next to Somaya Reece in the morning. I don't have time to look at nobody else. Have y'all seen her Instagram? Jesus Christ.
All right, listen. Now that you got a lot going on, because I'm great clothes out. She
praise
always
God, right? Terrell interviewed me when I had nothing going on. He's like, "What's going on, Luck?" I don't know, Terrell, you just asked me to come by.
Right, and that is true. She gave me three words, but I was figuring it out.
Oh,
listen,
yeah.
Would you go back to battle?
No, I can't. My girlfriend won't let me.
What?
No.
I would have to pay at least $1 million.
Well, but that's great. That's great. You got a great person behind you that will articulate the situation.
Maybe two.
I don't want to rap.
You wouldn't.
It don't make no sense.
It's disappointing. Like, let's talk about my last battle because I loved the little muffin top. You know, what happened there was very disappointing because even though she had some dope lines, I owned the building that night. Now, she had some dope shit, but I couldn't hear it because it was like, if it was like a boxing fight, you know, like her, she was coming out swinging like this. You know, I was so cool, collected, floating like a butterfly, and I'm not just giving myself credit, you know. I didn't like all the screaming I did between rounds, but, you know, and it's like I owned the building.
Bulletproof. Y'all scream, we in the building, we on the motherfucking roof. Lyrically been the Gucci since Triple Fat Goose. Fresher than produce, loose screws and short fuse. Tell them, call a truce, I go hard, I don't lose. Draw like Walt Disney on all you goof troops. That goes for hosts too, even transgender, any other.